In Surah Al-Baqarah, second chapter of the Quran, in ayah number 102, Allah the Almighty declares that Prophet Solomon, peace be upon him, is free from the false accusation and the myth that Bani Israel have accused him with. Banu Israel accused Prophet Solomon, and he is actually one of their prophets. But they falsely accused him of being a sorcerer and of having the capacity of communicating with the jinn and the birds, animals and insects, and commanding the wind to be subservient to him. So they said he was able to do that through practicing sorcery and magic. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defended Sulaiman alayhi salam, and he explained. He said, وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانُ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرِ. Suleiman never disbelieved. Yet those who disbelieved were the devils who have recited during the reign of Suleiman sorcery. It wasn't Suleiman who disbelieved, but the devils did disbelieve. Teaching people magic and that which was revealed to the two angels of Babylon, Harut and Marut, and that's another story. But with regards to this segment of the ayah begins with وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُو الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ. We have learned before that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the jinn subservient to Suleiman, made the wind subservient to Suleiman. تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ رُخَاءً حَيْثُ أَصَابْ وَالشَّيَاطِينَ كُلَّ بَنَّاءٍ وَغَوَّاصٍ. So all the jinn were at his service. Some would dive in the oceans and the seas in order to bring the pearls and the precious stones. Some were being used as laborers in building lofty buildings, and the wind was made subservient to him to carry whichever load he wishes with the speed of the wind from point A to point B. And then we all know that in Surah An-Naml, or the ant, that Suleiman alayhi salam was able to communicate with the birds, the hoopoe, and with the ants, and he was able to hear what they say. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with two things that only his father was blessed with before, which is both the prophethood and the kingdom, because the very first one to combine both blessings to be a king and a prophet was Prophet David alayhi salam. Then afterward, his son Prophet Suleiman alayhi salam. فلما خر تبينت الجن أن لو كانوا يعلمون الغيب ما لبثوا في العذاب. This segment of the ayah tells us that when Suleiman alayhi salam died, he died while resting on his skin. And his body became stiff, and he remained like that for so long. It was said for a year. And the jinn were working hard. And they were afraid to look behind, because whoever will disobey Suleiman alayhi salam would chain them, imprison them, and torture them of the jinn and Satan's. So when a turmoil started Eden, the kin, and then he lost balance and he fell on the side, the jinn realized that لو كانوا يعلمون الغيبة, had they known the unseen, they wouldn't have remained working for so long, for a whole year, and being tormented. They would have been free, because Suleiman is dead. And no one was given the power and the control over Satan's or the jinn other than Prophet Suleiman alayhi salam. And that's why he invoked Allah the Almighty. So this blessing which Suleiman alayhi salam enjoyed was as a result of a dua. رَبِّ هَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي. He said, my Lord, grant me a domain and a kingdom that will not be given to anyone after me. We also know that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam captured Satan, who was trying to interrupt his prayer. And he said, I was about to fasten him against one of the poles of the masjid so that the kids would play with him. Yani, they would see him, visualize him physically and say, this is shaitan. And here I chained him against one of the poles of the masjid. Then I just remembered the supplication of my brother Suleiman when he said, Rabbi habli mulka la yanbaghi li ahadin min ba'di. So I thought, well, I'm not going to disappoint him. And I'm not going to take control over the jinn. And he let him go. From that we understand that Suleiman alayhi salam was given such great givings, miracles, that no other prophet was given. The power of communicating with all the creations, which we don't know what they say, whether the animals or the birds or even the insects and the fish. The power of controlling the wind, having full control over the jinn kind, that they were made subservient to him and they were working for him, obeying his commands, subhanallah. And then when Suleiman alayhi salam died, all of that was an introduction to explain what is the meaning of وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانُ وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانُ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرِ. So when he died, the jinn, they stuffed a lot of books about sorcery and how to practice magic in his safe. So when Banu Israel, the children of Israel, whom Suleiman alayhi salam was one of the prophets who have been sent to them, troublemakers, they opened the stores and the warehouses and the safes of Suleiman alayhi salam, and they found those records. So they say, oh, this is how Suleiman was controlling the jinn and having power of communicating with the animals and the birds, even though he was the prophet. And they know very well that sorcery is haram. And those who practice sorcery are only shayateen and the jinn, and they're allies. And that's why Allah said, he blamed Bani Israel, the Israelites said, وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانِ. They followed what the Satans recited and claimed about Suleiman, peace be upon him. وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانُ. Allah the Almighty proved his innocence and his infallibility. Suleiman never disbelieved. So what did they claim about him? The Jews, Banu Israel, they said that Suleiman was having control over all of that via the power of sorcery. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed he didn't. And furthermore, he said, وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانِ. I understand out of that that if Suleiman was practicing sorcery, then he would have become kafir. But Allah said, مَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانِ. Suleiman did not disbelieve. Suleiman never practiced sorcery. Suleiman never learned, nor taught, or practiced magic and sorcery. وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا. Allah exposed, it was Satan's. He exposed them. They disbelieved because of the utilization of sihr. Accordingly, and to jump into conclusion, learning sorcery, practicing sorcery, or utilization of sorcerers, or visiting them, simply means kufr. Because وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانُ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا.